Hi students, today we are doing the second question of decimal fractions in page 30. The first question and the second question, using voltage to explain why 1 by 8 and 11 by 100, 100 and 11 by 1000, etc. of any number, get closer and closer to 1 by 9 of that distance. We have studied yesterday fractions to the denominators powers of time, getting closer to the real fraction. Here, let x be the number in the first time, and we give x, let x be the number. And here also the fraction the nearby at 1. Denominator turning the powers of the fractions along the side. But if you see the number, 1 by 9, so x is the number. Then 1 by 10 of x is equal to 1 by 10 in x. So we have x by 10. Therefore, 1 by 9 of x is 1 by 9 into x is x by 9. Now, we can find the difference between x by 9 and x by 10. X by 9 and x by 10 is equal to x by 9 minus x by 10. Now cross multiply 10x minus 9x. 10x minus 9x divided by 9 into 10 that is 90. So 10x minus 9x is 1x. So x by 90. So I will calculate the fraction by difference. 1 by 10 is the number x by 10, x by number and x by 10 in 10 powers are the denominator, 10 powers are the fractions in the nearest fraction in the number of the number. So, today, power of 9 in the number of the number of the number difference the number of x by 9 is the number of the fraction. Now, 1 by 100 of x is x by 100 and not 1 by 100, 11 by 100, that is 11x by 100. 1 by 9 of x is equal to x by 9. Now the difference between, therefore, difference between 11x by 100 and x by 9 is equal to x by 9 minus 11x by 100. So, cross multiplying we have 100x minus 99x divided by 100 into 900. 100x minus 99x, 1x that is x by 900. First of all, actually difference of 1 by x by 10 and x by 900 difference x by 90. X by 9, 11x by 100 and difference of x by 900. Similarly, between 1 x by 1000 and x by 9. That is x by 9 minus 111 x by 1000. Now cross multiply 1000 x minus 111 x by 9000. Then we have 999. So again, x divided by 9000. Therefore, the fractions are x by 10, next is 11x by 100, next is 11x by 1000, etc. Closer and closer to. X by 10, isn't it? X by 10, 11x by 100, 111x by 1000, etc. are closer and closer to x by 9. The x by 9, another total fraction. So x by 10, x by 9, another total fraction. Not a total fraction, 11. Therefore, we can eliminate x, which implies that 1 by 10. 11 by 100, 111 by 1000, etc. are closer and closer to here 1 by 9. In the next question, using the general principle board above to single digit numbers to find the decimal forms of 2 by 9. We would have 1 by 9 in a closer fraction 1 by 10, 11 by 100, 111 by 1000 is used. 2 by 9 is the fraction, closer fraction 4 by 9, 5 by 9, 7 by 9, and 8 by 9. In the second question, we know that one by 10, 11 by 100, 111 by 1000, etc. are fractions closer to 1 by 9. Therefore, two by 9 is equal to, which implies that 1 by 9 is equal to 1 by 10, 11 by 100, 1000, 111 by 1000, etc. So 2 by 9 is 2 by 10, 22 by 100. 222 divided by 1000, etc. Which implies that 2 by 9 is equal to 0.222, etc. This is the 2 by 9. Here, what about 1 by 9? 1 by 9 we have studied in the first question. Other question is remember. 1 by 9 is 0.111, etc. Isn't it? Similarly, 4 by 9, 4 by 9 is equal to 1 by 9 is equal to 0.111, etc. Therefore, 4 by 9 is equal to 0.444, etc. And 5 by 9 is equal to 0.555, etc. And 7 by 9 is equal to 0.777, etc. And 8 by 9, is equal to 0.888 x. Examination ഒരു question find the cos of fraction 2/9 ചോദിച്ചു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ തിരുത്തപ്പെടുന്നു. We know that 1/10 11/100 111/1000 etc. fractions cos of 1/9. So 4/9 is but 1/9 is 0.111 etc. therefore 2/9 is 0.22 etc. 3/9 is 0.333 etc. isn't it? Here is the answer. Third question, homework.
Third question.
अरे समझ रहा हूँ बात तो ये बोला चेयर का क्वेश्चन है. നമ്മൾ 1/9 ഡെസിമൽ ഫോംസ് കണ്ടുപിടിച്ചു, അതേപോലെ 1/11 ഡെസിമൽ ഫോം കണ്ടുപിടിക്കണം. അത് കണ്ടുപിടിച്ച് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് 2/11 കിട്ടും, 3/11 കിട്ടും, 10/11 കിട്ടും. ഏതാണ് അതിനനുസരിച്ച് കഥ ഉണ്ടാകുന്ന കിട്ടും. അടുത്ത നെക്സ്റ്റ് ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ write the results of the operations, below as questions.
Here we can reference 10/9 one time, and omega is 1.
1 by 9. It is 1 by 9. 1 by 9 is 1 plus 1 by 9, but 1 by 9 is 0.111. 1 plus 0.111 etc. That is 1.111 etc. This is the answer. Example. Now the question is, that is 0.222 etc. Now fourth question. 0.333 etc. Of course. Here 0.333. Therefore, etc. is equal to 3 by 9. Therefore, 0.333 etc. whole square is equal to 3 by 9 the whole square. 3 by 9 is 1 by 3 the whole square. That is 1 by 9. That is equal to 0.111 etc. Is it? Elaborate in terms of 1 by 9 and number of 10. Now the next question is, point 4, 4, 4 here it can be as therefore root of 0.444 etc. can be as 4 into 0.111 etc. That is 4 into 1 by 9. That is root of 4 is 2. Root of 9 is 3. 2 by 3 can be written as 2 into 3 divided by 3 into 3. That is 6 by 9. Therefore, the denominator 9 is 1 by 9, 0.111. So 6 by 9 is 0.666 etc. Follow this. ഈ ചാപ്റ്ററിൽ ടെക്സ്റ്റൽ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻസ് എല്ലാം നമ്മൾ കമ്മ്യൂണിക്കും, പക്ഷെ ഇതിനകത്ത് കുറച്ച് ഫോർമുലാസ് പറഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ട്. ആ ഫോർമുലാസ് അതിനെ ബേസ് ചെയ്യുന്ന ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻസ് അടുത്ത ക്ലാസ്സിലാക്കണം.